I bring you good news of great joy, which will come to all people. For to you is born this day a Saviour, Christ the Lord. Beloved, we are come together in the presence of Almighty God and of the whole company of heaven to offer unto him through our Lord Jesus Christ our worship and praise and thanksgiving, to make confession of our sins, to pray as well for others as for ourselves, that we may know more truly the greatness of God's love and show forth in our lives the fruits of his grace, and to ask on behalf of all people such things as their well-being doth require. Wherefore, let us sit or kneel in silence and remember God's presence with us now. Let us confess our sins to Almighty God. O God, our Father,
we have sinned against thee in thought, word, and deed.
We have not loved thee with all our heart. We have not loved our neighbours as ourselves.
Have mercy on us, we beseech thee.
Cleanse us of our sins, and help us to overcome our faults.
Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
The Almighty and merciful Lord grant unto you pardon and remission of all your sins, time for amendment of life, and the grace and comfort of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen.
Thank you. lesson from the book of the prophet Isaiah, chapter 65, beginning at the 17th verse. I am about to create new heavens and a new earth. The former things shall not be remembered or come to mind. But be glad and rejoice forever in what I am creating. For I am about to create Jerusalem as a joy, and its people as a delight. I will rejoice in Jerusalem and delight in my people. No more shall the sound of weeping be heard in it, or the cry of distress. No more shall there be in it an infant that lives but a few days, or an old person who does not live out a lifetime. For one who dies at 100 years will be considered a youth, and one who falls short of 100 will be considered accursed. They shall build houses and inhabit them. They shall plant vineyards and eat their fruit. They shall not build and another inhabit. They shall not plant and another eat. For like the days of a tree shall the days of my people be, and my chosen shall long enjoy the work of their hands. They shall not labor in vain or bear children for calamity, for they shall be offspring blessed by the Lord, and their descendants as well. Before they call, I will answer. While they are yet speaking, I will hear. The wolf and the lamb shall feed together. The lion shall eat straw like the ox, but the servant, its food, shall be dust. They shall not hurt or destroy on all my holy mountain, says the Lord. Here ends the first lesson.
Oh, Paul's letter to the Philippians, chapter 2, beginning at the 5th verse. Let the same mind be in you that was in Christ Jesus, who, though he was in the form of God, did not regard equality with God as something to be exploited, but emptied himself, taking the form of a slave, being born in human likeness. And, being found in human form, he humbled himself and became obedient to the point of death, even death upon the cross. Therefore God also exalted him and gave him the name that is above every name, so that at the name of Jesus every knee should bend, in heaven and on earth and under the earth, and every tongue should confess that Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. Here ends the second lesson.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty,
maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Ghost, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried, he descended into hell, the third day rose again from the dead, he descended into heaven, and sits upon the right hand of God, the Father Almighty.
greetings as we gather this evening on Christmas Day, and Christmas greetings to you all. The parents of a newborn child brought their new baby home from hospital for the first time. It was evening, and the tiny wee tot was asleep after the ride home in the car, so they quietly put the baby in the nursery upstairs. They plugged in the baby monitor so they could hear if the child woke up. In the meantime, they went down and had a cup of Milo. After a while, they heard the pitter-patter of little feet upstairs. It was the 2.5-year-old sibling walking in to see the new baby. The parents listened to the baby monitor to hear what the older child would say. This is what the older child said to the newborn baby: "Will you tell me what God is like? Because I have almost forgotten." On this Christmas Day, we gather to celebrate the birth of Christ, who came to show us at first hand what God is like. The scripture readings today proclaim God, full of grace and truth, coming to dwell among us in human form. God loves the world so much that he came from eternity and entered our world in a particular time and place to be fully present among us as a human being, sharing our humanity even to the point of risking rejection and death. We gather to give thanks for our new birth and baptism, that God has opened a way for us to be like Christ, that is, to be born not merely of human desire, but of God. Because of the birth of Christ, we can reach out and hold in our own hands the grace and truth shown to us in Jesus. For a lot of people around us, though, the celebration of Christmas lacks this mystical dimension. For many weeks now, the city has glutted itself on Christmas carols, Christmas decorations, Christmas parties, Christmas shopping. There's nothing wrong with that. I, for one, enjoy the parties and sometimes even the shopping. The point I'm making, though, is that the focus on materialism, getting presents, often conceals hollow lives bereft of any joy beyond the present moment of getting, and any love beyond the narrow boundaries of self. The need to get presents so often conceals other deep, unmet human needs. The point of this day is that God comes to meet us in Jesus at the point of our need. God comes to nurture us, to call us out of loneliness and alienation into a new community. He comes to bring hope into our lives, not only for ourselves, but for the suffering world all around us. That's why we pray and sing together that our God at last reigns among us in the child of Mary, Jesus our Lord. The gospel then calls us to look around this world we're in and to see it through the eyes of faith, through the same eyes of Christ, who loved this world enough to become part of it. When we look around, we see so much brokenness on the international stage, wars in Northeast Africa and in Ukraine, and the world facing a climate crisis that is threatening water supplies, food sources, and damaging livelihoods and communities. COVID is still out and about, and many of us have faced a trying year. Our calling as God's people is to look for ways of being God's messengers of peace and good news to all who suffer in our world. It may seem that the international problems of the world are too big for us to do much about, but we can begin with seeking peace in our own hearts and working for reconciliation in our relationships. Our families are often a very good place to start. Family rifts and wounds can linger on for years, and when we see how hard it is to bring healing just to these situations, then we can see how difficult it is to bring peace in other parts of the world. So our own hearts and family relationships are a good place to start in terms of working for peace in our troubled world. And that means we need to be ready to overcome our prejudice, to ask God for healing for past wrongs, to be ready to forgive those who have hurt us in the past. But of course we need to go further than our own families and friends. In this city there are plenty of people who need us to be God's good news for them: the poor, the hungry, the elderly, the infirm, the lonely, the sick, the mentally ill, and those who are dying. Of course, through the eye of faith, we see more than the suffering of the world. The eye of faith also discerns the child of Mary making his way to the cross, begging us to help him carry its burden. This child of Mary will make sure that our celebration does not stop here, but it will lead us all the way to Good Friday and then into the light of Easter Day, because it is for the healing of the whole of creation that the eternal Word of God became flesh and lived among us, so that the power of death may be defeated, our lives may be filled with God, so that we may offer a new song of thanks and praise. May I take this opportunity to wish you all a peaceful and joyful and holy Christmas and a happy New Year. Thanks be to God. Let us pray. Today, the angel's message rings through the world, Gathered together in prayer, we rejoice in the birth of our brother, the Saviour of us all. We ask, O Lord, that your birth will bring us your peace. We pray that you will be indwelling our hearts, that our lives may express what we celebrate. May the mystery of this day enrich your people all over the world. Lord, hear our prayer and let our cry come to you. We join with the shepherds in adoring you. We kneel before you, Holy Child of Bethlehem. We pray for all those who have a shepherding role in your church. We pray for priests, pastors, and bishops, for those who have responsibility for the care of your people. Be close to them as they proclaim your birth to your holy people. Lord, hear our prayer and let our cry come to you. As we travel on this earthly pilgrimage, may your light shine in our hearts. May we see your glory born in our midst. Word of the Father, you became human for us and raised us to a new life. May the dead share with us in the new birth which Christmas proclaims. Lord, hear our prayer and let our cry come to you. In a moment of silence, we offer our own particular prayers to God. Lord, hear our prayer and let our cry come to you. God, our Father, our human nature is the wonderful work of your hands, made still more wonderful by your work of redemption. Your Son took to himself our humanity. Grant us a share in the Godhead of Jesus Christ, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, for ever and ever. Amen. May Christ, our infant Saviour, give you the joy of the Bethlehem shepherds, the awe of the worshipping sages, and the humility and love of the Holy Family. The blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be upon you this night and remain with you always.